Today we are visiting the Marche region in central Italy, visiting a natural phenomenon in Genga. Andiamo! Genga is an Italian town of 1,671 inhabitants in the province of Ancona. Upon arriving at the train station, you are about a 10-minute walk away from the tourist center that sells local products and foods to tourists, along with being a departure point for tourists to visit the nearby attractions. From this point, you can take a shuttle included with your admission ticket to take you from this area directly to the awe-inspiring Frasassi Caves, which are what I came to check out. The Frasassi Caves are underground karst caves that are located within the regional natural park of the Gola della Rossa and Frasassi in the hamlet of San Vittore Terme. It's a complex formed by a series of caves, the first of which can be visited from the current entrance is the Abisso Ancona. It's so large, over 2 million meters cubed, that the Cathedral of Milan could be contained inside. Inside the Frasassi Caves, there is throughout the year a constant temperature of 14 degrees Celsius and a relative humidity close to 100%. Inside the cavities, you can admire natural sculptures formed by calcareous stratifications over 190 million years, thanks to the work of water and rock. Since 1972, it's been under the protection of the Frasassi Consortium, made up of the municipality of Genga and the province of Ancona, with the aim of safeguarding and enhancing its scientific and tourist usability. About a million years ago, the Sentino River flowed much higher in the gorge than its current altitude. Its waters penetrated inside large areas inside the massive limestone bank that forms the Frasassi Gorge. These cold waters encountered rising sulfurous water with which they mixed, increasing the breakdown of the limestone rock, creating enormous voids and generating the entire system of caves in the following millennia. The water, conveying the carbon dioxide in the limestone rocks, creates a chemical process that gives rise to calcium hydrogen carbonate. This phenomenon determines the transfer of small quantities of calcium carbonate from one place to another, and in the course of a dripping which lasts a millennia, ends up forming curious shapes. The combinations within are divided into stalagmites, which are columns growing from the bottom upwards, and stalactites, which instead descend from the ceiling of the cavities. Since the 1st of September 1974, part of the caves has been open to the public, becoming over time one of the major tourist attractions in La Marche. It's been estimated that there have been over 12 million total visits since then. Nearby the caves, there's some other fantastic attractions and sights to see. The Temple of Valadier and Hermitage of the Santa Maria in Frasassi. They're two religious structures created at the entrance to a cave in the same valley as the Frasassi Caves. Also, the Abbey of San Vittore alle Chiuse is the most important monument that rises in the municipal area and one of the best examples of Romanesque architecture in Le Marche. One thing to make notice, since the area has less of a transport system, a car is truly necessary to explore these places. Upon speaking to the tourist center, besides the shuttle itself that go to the caves, I was unable to locate a bus, a taxi service, or any other alternate to visit these sites. Thankfully, that just means I'll have to return next time to see them. It was a tease to be so close. I really hope you all enjoyed this unique tour and a brief visit into the Le Marche region. Until next time, alla prossima! Did you enjoy this episode? Please hit the like button and subscribe to be in the know for future episodes.